Good evening. Good evening. Welcome to Truth in Action Bible Study. I am Pastor Kyle, and I'm excited to have you tonight. Hope all is well. Come on in. Join with me. Like, share, and tag. Find someone that you can connect with and bring them to Bible study tonight with you. Let them know that you'll be in Bible study tonight. I see you, Brianna Lane. I see you, Brandy Lane. The whole family. I see you, Raquel, Kyle, Tarika Hood. Come on in. It's going to be an amazing night that we're going to have an opportunity to bless the Lord in a different kind of way. Tarika Hood, I see you. Maria Alexandria, Teresa Hall, Florence, come on. Tawanda Carr, Minister Tamla Ritz. I know it's different for y'all looking at me in the sanctuary, but looking at me outside the sanctuary. It's amazing, I'm sure. And so, hey, Chandria, good to see you. Renita Holloway, come on in. Y'all are doing a real good job tonight, making sure that everyone is able to fellowship and gather together in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Come on, y'all. I'm excited about it. I hope you are. Amen. It's going to be a good night tonight. We're going to have a wonderful time tonight. And I hope you're ready for what's going to happen tonight. I really hope that you're ready just for all of it. Hey, Nicole Abbott, I see you. Linnell McFarlane, Renita Holloway, Mr. Holloway, Ivan Rice, Crystal Burton, Cause Divine, I see you as well. Come on in, Mabel Rice and the Rice family. I want y'all to go gather somebody, like, share, tag someone. Tell them it's Bible study time and we're ready to gather together in the name of the Lord. Tammy Nicholas, I see you over on YouTube. Erica Best over on YouTube. Gerald and Wiley Shelvin, God bless you. Good to see you as well. I'm just ready, y'all. I've been ready all day. Hello, Kiara, good to see you. Sarah Price, come on in. Terrence Bell, how you doing? Just got out of surgery. Wonderful. Y'all supposed to text me on the way in, but I got you, Terrence Bell. Praise God for her being out well. Hello, Nikki. God bless you. Good to see you as well. Good evening, First Lady. First Lady pops out. There she is right there, y'all. She's good. Good evening to all. She wants to say that. And so I'm excited about tonight. And so we're going to be a blessing to you. Tanya Green, good to see you. It was a wonderful pleasure to see you in person on Sunday. Wonderful. Wonderful pleasure. And so Ashley Prevost, come on in, come on in. And so I want to just get y'all ready for tonight. I have to be ready by 7. I have to be off by 7:45. That was my promise to the group that is settling in the sanctuary right now. Hello, Lady Carol Thomas, good to see you. And Chris Mouton, good evening. Tamisha Figaro, how you doing? So I'm excited because I wanted to make sure everyone gets the opportunity to get in. They're still working on my Facebook. So as you see, we're able to do it on First Facebook Live and on YouTube. So I hope that you all got it. And I'm getting ready to go share it again. Yeah. Hey, Lester Blunt, good to see you, man. Emery Shelvin, how you doing, man? Crystal Mouton, I'm getting ready to share it again because I know it's going to be a good night. I think the preacher got something to say. I think it's going to be, awesome tonight, so I'm gonna share it again. I think I'm gonna do that. How about that? So get ready, y'all. Get your pen, get your paper, get your minds, get your hearts ready. It's gonna be a word tonight, and I need you to trust the word tonight. I need you to trust the word. Minister Ricks, hello, Denai, good to see you. I'm doing one thing here and we'll be ready. I'm making sure we get this together and so we can do that together tonight. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. I'm excited, y'all. I'm excited. I hope y'all are ready for this word. So we'll be ready to do whatever God wants us to do tonight. And Mr. Mays, thank you for the wonderful music. Sydney, God bless you, man. Good to see you, sir. Hope all is well. In Jesus' name. Hey, Trish Wells, good evening. Good evening. God bless. Father, we thank you tonight for your word. We thank you for those that will gather in your name. We thank you for those that will come together to trust you in every area of our life. We give you praise, honor, and glory in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Listen, y'all, I hope you are ready for tonight. There is a word from the Lord that we must get to that I really want to push in your spirits. I know I've got this together. That's what I wanted. Now I'm done with that. I wanted to get this together so I can make some things happen tonight. And so, Akara Dulu, I see you. Cynthia, I see you over there. CC Cartwright, I see you. or let's just get into the word tonight. So, Father, we praise you. We magnify you in Jesus' name. And for those in the sanctuary, God bless you. Thank you for chiming in tonight. Listen, where we are in our lives right now, you have to know that the word works. You have to know that the word works. Come on, Trish, follow me. You have to know that the word works. Because if you don't know that the word works, I think Sydney said it best today, you will start coming up with your own logic. And when you replace your place the word of God with your logic, that's going to be an issue. Hello, Fletcher. Good to see you. And so the word of God is sent to us, not just for us to have and not just for us to fellowship with, not just for us to have around. The word of God is sent to us for something. Every time the word of God is sent to us, it's sent for something. Hey, Tonita, good to see you. Every time the word of God is sent for something. And we need to understand it's not just sent to hang around. It's not just sent to give us an option. It is sent to prepare us for something. And let me give you scripture. So, hey, Don, good to see you. Isaiah chapter 55, verse 8 says, "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, said the Lord." Verse 9 says, "For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts." Verse 10 says, "For as the rain cometh down and snow from heaven," rain comes down, snow from heaven, and "return not thither, but water the earth, and make it bring forth in bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater." What it's saying is, just like the water, the rain comes down, it has a particular purpose that it serves. And that purpose leads to a purpose. And that purpose leads to a purpose. And then verse 11 gives us clarity. It says, "So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish." It shall achieve. It shall make manifest. It shall prove results. "That which I please, and it shall prosper." Hey, Karen Ricks. "And it shall prosper." What's up, Chris? "It shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it." Which means there's nothing that God does that in his word he sends to us that is not sent to prosper us. It shall prosper us. The problem is most of us are impatient, but the word of God is still sent to prosper us and to prosper in the thing whereto I sent it. I see you, Tammy Nicholas. It shall. That's it. It shall. I see you. It shall. That's it. And so you have to understand that the word will prosper. Y'all got it? The word will prosper. The word will prosper. Yeah, it shall, Geraldine. I see you. Listen, it will prosper. And so the word of God sent to us, it's sent to us to accomplish a goal or to accomplish something that God has set forth for us. And it shall not be returned to him until it has accomplished what it is. But the Bible says, when you read it, it says, "It shall not return unto me void." It means it shall not go back to him until it's in manifestation form. Until we have been developed, until the word has been dropped into our life, dropped into our lap, dropped into our wisdom and our understanding, where we can understand it and apply it. That word has to remain with us until it's in manifestation form. Now, what we do with the word after it's been dropped off and delivered into our lives is totally up to us. Oh my God, I feel my help coming already. I should have went to the church and just hung out with them and Minister Mays. We'd have had a good time tonight. Hey, First Lady, come on. I'm trying to stay calm. I got to stay on my mark tonight. So. And the reason why you have to honor the word, Maria, as the word that cannot return to him void, because sometimes We extend the stay. I'm going to chase a rabbit already. I feel it. We extend the stay of God's word in our life. God's word comes to give us what we need, and then it returns to him, but it does not return to him void. It returns to him accomplished, but it shall accomplish that which I please, which means it goes back to God accomplished, manifested, and pleasing to God. And then it says, shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it, which means it goes back to him saying, I left the blessing of prosperity and acceleration where you sent me. Now, what we do with that word is up to us, but we know that the word of God will prosper. I gotta go. Jesus. Okay. So the word of God has to be sent back to God. When it goes back in manifestation form, which means it's already accomplished what it's supposed to do. Now, the question is, if we don't come into an area where we are accomplished, we can't blame it on the word. Let me go a little further. People have, or we have, saints have, people period have, we have overlooked the word. We have underrated the word. We have improperly handled the word, especially the prophetic word of God. We've improperly handled it from God and from the prophets of God. Because we get a word and we take a word as an option, not a word as instruction. Gotta go. Gotta get quickly. And so I remember years ago when I first met Lester Blunt, I didn't know him very well. Years ago, when I met him and his wife, and he said something to her, and she said, oh man. And he said, man, see how you handle me? And I had never heard that term before. Like, how you handle me. Like, what you mean? I said, man, you handle me rough. And I'm like, she didn't put her hands on him. She didn't do anything. It's just how she responded to him with her work. That was way back then. Then since then, I've heard other couples, I guess, pick it up from them and try to use it. You know, my wife handled me, or my husband handled me. And I was trying to figure out, like, y'all go into this phrase about how somebody handles you. My question is, how do you handle the word of God in your life? How do you handle the thing that God sent to make himself happy? It pleased him, and then to prosper him. Y'all, that was years ago. They real good now. You know, the Blunts are real good. That was years ago. It kicked up, and I realized when I was typing, I said, I remember he used that word, how, you know, watch how you handle me. And God is saying, I need y'all to watch how you handle my word in this season. My word is made to prosper you, to bless you, to change you, to shift you. I need you to watch how you handle my word. Listen, y'all, go find somebody. It's gonna get great in a minute. I need you to watch how you handle my word. And so understand, when you watch how we've overlooked, underrated, improperly handled, and mishandled the word of God, because hearing is not enough. Hearing, faith comes by hearing, but faith is exemplified and goes out by the words of our mouth, Maria. It goes out by the words of our mouth. And so there must be, after you've heard the word, there must be a repeating of the word. Okay, y'all got it? You know, there must be a repeating of the word. There must be a doing of the word. There must be a hearing of the word. There must be a trusting of the word. Or if you don't, you will come into a place where there won't be a manifestation of the word. And so you got to repeat the word by saying it with your mouth and then doing it in the earth, because there's nothing God can do in the earth unless we say it with our mouth. That's what prayer is for. Well, if God is God, then what must we do? We must pray and talk to God in his language. I'm going to talk about that much later, because there's a language for everything. There's a language for entrepreneurship. There's a language for marriage. There's a language for friendship. There's a language for relationship. There's a language for leadership. There's a language for, you know, there's a language for everything. And if you don't learn the language of the area that you're in, you'll be speaking a language that the people around you won't be able to manifest or increase or profit from. You must be able to use the language of that season or the language of that place. You got it? Okay, gotta move. And so we have to hear the word. Once we hear the word, we must repeat the word and do the word. Because the reason why we have prayers is for us to say what is said by God in the heavens in the earth. Come on. I'm trying to lift the blood. I'm using everybody and everything I can to get this thing crossed. Listen, you know, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven, which means we need to say what is said in the heaven, in the earth. That's when things shift. Oh my God. That's when things change. When we say in the earth what has already been said in the heavens, and then the heavens agree with us because we, you know, we speak what the heavens say in the earth and we hold on to it with our faith. Some people cannot speak what the heavens say because they don't know what his word says. Let me go a little further. Carlos, when you are born again, I feel like preaching. Let me calm down. I'm a Bible study. When you get born again, the destination of your life changes. All the rules you have, all the, you know, the things on your mind, the vision board, all the proper things, all the pictures, everything you set up for your life changes when you get born again. I'm hurrying, Mr. Mays, when you get born again. That's why when you pray, not my will, but thy will be done. It means I had my own, but now that I've gotten saved, I choose your will because your will was set up for my life. Your will was destined for my life. And so with that be saying, thy will be done, that means we have to deal with what the blockages are, because what is it in our life that's keeping us? I didn't give y'all my subject yet, did I? I got happy already. What's blocking your next move? What's blocking you from going to the next thing? I want to help you. I really want to push you. What's keeping you from getting to the proper things that God has designed for your life? Here is another blockage that God has given. I want to talk tonight. If I was to preach in church, I would talk, in the new church, I would talk about what's blocking your move. Okay? What's blocking your move? If I was to preach to church people, I would talk about the process of forgiving and forgetting. You know, the old saying is to forgive is to forget. I'm coming at with Caesar. To forgive is to forget. I'm trying, Gerald, I'm trying the best I can. To forgive is to forget, but I got to get you. To forgive is to forget and to forego some things. Can we move further? Okay, let me talk. Let me calm down. Because we think we know what forgiving is, and I'll talk more about it in a minute. And we think we know what forgiving is, and I'll talk more about it. Forgetting, and I'll talk more about that in a minute. But we don't know what to forego means. To forego some things. Colette, here we go. To forego means, Mr. Mays, it means to omit or to decline to take something. Something that's normally of pleasure or of value. I'm coming, Brianna. A pleasure or a value, or to go without, to give up something. Watch this. Something that's an enjoyment. Remember, when you get saved, everything wasn't horrible. Everything wasn't bad. There's some stuff that you enjoyed. There's some stuff we enjoyed, but we had to forgive, forget, and forego. We had to decline to take something that was a pleasure or a value. We had to go without some things. I'll give you one. It's like when you know you're working on working out, Minister Ricks, and you're trying to do some things. CC Cartwright, Chandria, you're working on something, and you go to a restaurant, and you have to get somewhere at the proper time. And you know, watch this, Carlos. If you decide to get the dessert, they're going to make it fresh. So dessert's going to do two things. It's going to cost you more money than you want to spend. It's going to put more weight on you than you want to have. And it may make you late for your next destination. So you say, you know what? I'll forego that. Even though I want it, it's good to me, but I'll forego it. I'll let it go. I'll decline it. And even though it's with pleasure, I'll go without. Let me go somewhere. And so when you deal with the process of forgiving and forgetting, we deal with the forego. We got that. Let's deal with this process of forgiving and forgetting, because we get to an area where we have to lock ourselves in to keep ourselves from being blocked out. So I want to deal with the process of forgiving and forgetting. Listen, Philippians chapter 3, if you have your Bibles, Philippians chapter 3, verse 12 says, not as though I had already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend that for which also I am apprehended of Christ Jesus. I'm following after. I'm going after some things that I may get what I'm really going after with Christ Jesus. Listen, it's 62 of you on here. 32 of you have liked it. Go ahead and like the post wherever you are. Like and love it. Then verse 13 says this, brethren, my sisters, to watch this. I count not myself to have apprehended. I don't act like I've already got it all together. But this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind me, reaching forth to those things which are before me, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Verse 14 says, yeah, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Verse 14 says, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. But 14 says, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Verse 15 says, let us therefore, as many as be perfect, be thus minded. And if in anything you be otherwise minded, God shall reveal even this unto you. What are you saying, preacher? What are you saying? Please help me understand what you're saying. I'm saying if there's a bigger issue, I'm coming up on Pat. If there's a bigger issue, God said, don't worry. If anybody else is not on the same accord, I'm going to reveal it to you. Don't you worry. I will reveal it to you. Now, this scripture that reads, I love to read it because it says, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do. The one thing I do. It says one thing, but then it turns around and it gives you three things. Listen. Oh my God. Listen, even you on YouTube, I want you, when you get off, to go to first page and like this. I want to make sure we know who all is on here at one place. On YouTube, we can't see you, only on the live. But if you get through, go over to First Lady's page, Lady Tara Kyle, and just like this post. We'll know you were there. Can I go further? Listen, he says, this one thing I do, then he names three things. He names three things. Okay? He says one thing, but then he names three things. The one thing, what he's saying is, it's still one thing, Chandria. I'm coming, Kara Thomas. It's still one thing, but he says it's three parts that make up the whole. I'm coming. Listen, we know how to reach forth and we know how to press when we want to. When we want to. But here is the blocking that's been blocking. The blockage that's been blocking our move forward. Yeah, Maria, 3-1, Trinity, here it is. But here's what's been blocking us. Are you ready? Are you ready? Hope you're really ready. What's been blocking us is not knowing how to forget. Can I just talk about that? You know, I'm not going to do nothing regular as somebody else. It's we know how to reach forth and we know how to press. But it's the forgetting is the problem. It's the forgetting. The forgetting is our issue. Deja, it's forgetting. And so we have this problem in our lives. I'm trying to get it done, blunt. I'm trying to do my best. Listen. It's the forgetting because we think to forgive is to forget. Come on, Brittany. To forgive is to forget. But sometimes you have to get clarity on if that really means what it means. Because sometimes I have to forgive you when I remember. Sometimes, Lester Blunt, God allows me to remember so I can keep forgiving, so I can keep getting my heart in the right place. But it's that forgetting thing that becomes our problem. I'm at 24 minutes. I got to go. So we must understand that whatever the past was, whether good or bad, watch this. It was. I want you to just type, it was. Whatever the past was, If it was a bad pass, you got to forget it. Watch this. If it was a good pass, you got to forget it. So that really means forgetting must have another definition than what we think it means. I see y'all typing. It was. It jumped up here real quick. It means it must have another definition than what I think it is. You know, I think I see Archie Kyle saying it was. I see Brandy Lane. I see Ashley. I see it must be a different definition than what I thought it was. And so I have to make sure I jump out and say, okay, if that's the case, then help me, prophet, help me, because whether it's a good pass, I've got to forget it. because a bad pass will make you stay stuck if you don't forget it, Kiara. And then a good pass, okay, y'all don't. I'm trying to. How do I say it? Let me say it. Let me say it a different way, Trish. If it was a bad pass, we forget about it until we feel it, Erica Best. I see you. Until we feel it, and then when we feel it, we tend to think we've not forgiven because we feel it in our emotions. And you have to, now I told you, you have to control and manage your emotion. Just because you can think about it or remember it does not mean you have not forgiven or forgot it. I gotta explain what forgot it is so people can have clarity. We must understand that even in your past, if it was good, you gotta forget it. If it was bad, you gotta forget it. Let me go a little further. If you remember your bad past too long, you will repeat it. And you will repeat the emotions if you don't manage right. If you remember your good past, you will celebrate too long. And both of those will keep you from getting to what's next in your life. You won't go to what's next because of what was negative. You won't go to what's next because of what was good. And every time we ask you what's next, you go saying, let me tell you what I did. Let me tell you what was going on. Let me tell you what they did. Let me tell you what. And so you have to miss it. So even if it is bad or good, it was. But even since it was, Trish, here I come. It was, but it's not now. Even though it was, it's not now. And what was is not next. Deja. What was is not next. What's next is next. And what was is was. If it was something, come on, Donna Blunt, that's it. Don't get stuck. If God wanted what was to be what's next, I would still be there. But since he's moved me from it, evidently it can't be my next. It may be my development for my next, but it can't be my preaching voice. Come down. It can't be my next. So prophesy to yourself and tell yourself, since I know that my was and my is, prophesy to yourself and type, my best is yet to come. Come on. Type, my best is yet to come. Prophesy to yourself. Stop looking for me to text you, looking for me to call you. You prophesy to yourself. And how do you know that my best is yet to come? Because First Lady told us Sunday, if you stay in grace, grace is bringing your best to you. Can I give you scripture for it? You don't believe me? The Bible says, if you do the part, if you commit your way unto the Lord, I told you with the word of God, and trust also in him, and he shall bring it. There it is again. That it. He shall bring it. There it is. He shall bring, right there. He shall bring it to pass. Now, if he's going to bring it to pass, then you best know it's coming. Your best is yet to come. Amen. Okay. I got to go. So that's Psalms 37, verse 5. Your best. So let me show you why you know you're having to fight blocking what's good, what's bad, letting it go, forgiving, and forgetting. I see y'all typing, my best yet to come. I see you typing. But you have to understand, in order to know what's coming, what it is, I have to know what the will of God is. And let me show you why Sydney, Minister Ricks, Tawanda Carr, why some of you have been going through some things, why it's been difficult in your go through, why it's been a struggle in your go through. It's because God is getting you to the will of God for your life. He's getting you there. I give you Bible, Romans chapter 8, verse 27. It says it like this. And he that searcheth the hearts knoweth. Well, I told you, keep your heart pure. I tell some of y'all consistently, keep your heart pure. Because he is going to search your heart. He searches the heart, knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit. Because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. Here's verse 28. We know this one. We quote it all the time, but we don't finish the verse. We don't finish the word of God. We always quote what we like, and we know. that all the things I'm going through, they all work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose. Here is where we find out what the will of God is. Verse 29 says, for whom he did foreknow. Remember, you gotta forgive, to forget, to forego, to now foreknow. For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed. Y'all didn't get it. To be conformed. Watch this. Here's the will of God. To get you to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. What do you mean? He's saying simply, I'm doing, Maria, to get you to be conformed to the image of his dear son. All you're going through is simply to get you to look like Christ. I told you last week, dealing with your emotions, what would you do if you had to respond like Christ? He says, to be conformed to the image of his son. So all that God is doing and allowing is supposed to bring you to the place in your life where you respond and you act more like Jesus. More like Jesus. All you're going through is because you're not responding like Jesus. So you repeat that class again. But here's the deal. Remember, you know that all things are working together. So if you're still breathing, then you're still being worked on. You're still being worked on. But it goes back to the process of forgetting. I think we know how to press. I think we know how to, you know, what we should do to forgive. But it's the forgetting part. Sydney, here I come. It's the forgetting part that I'm about to open up your process, the process of your mind. It's the forgetting part. It's the process of forgetting. Okay, let me help you out. From the Greek, the word is epilenthonamia. Epilenthonamia. You got it? I'm going to give it to you so you'll know what it is. You can look it up yourself. There it is. You got it? It's epilenthonamia, which means to lose out of mind. That's what the word forget means. It means to lose out of mind. Now, I want you to pay attention. It did not say to lose out of your brain. It said to lose out of your mind. Remember, the Bible never said, let this brain be in you. That's the intellectual, logical side. That side doesn't work well. When he says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. The mind, that mind mean, that's the part that can be replaced. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, which mean I need to forget some of the things that are on my mind and replace it with things that are on his mind. Let's go, Fletcher. I'm gonna teach you now what forgetting really means. It means to lose out of mind. Again, it did not say brain, it said out of mind. Another version says it means to neglect, okay? To neglect or lose its place. I'm coming, Tim. I'm learning like you. I'm trying to do the best I can. It means to lose its place. Does not mean that it's being what it is, but it comes to lose its place. That means something is occupying space now in your mind that's taking up too much time because you won't replace it with the things that are in the mind of God. I'm coming somewhere now. So listen, understand this. So it means that something is taking up space. It's taking up residence. When you decide to forget, remember, forget those things which are behind me. You can't forget about it because you know what they are. What it means is I decide to cancel the lease. It can no longer occupy space that has now had a lease in my life because something greater is about to replace it. So here it is. That's why it says to neglect. It neglect means to no longer have or get your attention. If there's something or somebody in your life that are not serving you the greater purpose, all you have to do is start to neglect them, and they will eventually fall off or leave you alone. I gotta go. So whenever God is trying to help you forget something, you got it? He's trying to help you to forget. He makes you neglect what's on your mind by placing something greater right in front of you. Good God Almighty. Got it, Donna? Did you get it? So what God does, he says, I'm not telling you it's not present. I'm telling you not to give it power in your life. I decide to cancel these. You got to cancel it. Listen. Neglect is the part that says it's present, but I don't give it what it thinks it's worth. I give it what I think it's worth, and that's nothing. You get a cancel from me. That's all you get. And so it means, so whenever God wants to bless you, whenever God wants to push you, he pushes you into an area and places something bigger in front of you. The reason why your next has been blocked is because God places greater in front of you, and you neglect the greater because you've gotten comfortable with what is present in your life right now. So you extend the lease on something when you should have canceled the lease. Okay. It means to no longer have or get your attention. So when God is trying to help you to forget Renita Holloway, Mr. Holloway, I'm sorry. He makes you neglect what's on your mind by placing something greater right in front of you. And something greater should be, Joel and Wiley Shelvin, it should be so great that it should occupy all of you. It should occupy all of you. So when you choose not to forgive, you extend the lease of whatever takes up space that God would use to give you greater. But he can't give you greater because you won't forgive. So in not forgiving, you don't have a place to get rid of anything that you're holding on to, because you don't forgive, then God can't forgive you. The reason why he can't forgive you is because you have not given him place in your life. So you get caught up in your own cycle, holding your emotions and your feelings based on what you don't want to forgive. So therefore you cannot forget because you hang on to it too long. It becomes a part of you. And so what God does, he doesn't just tell you to forget. He don't say just forget. He shows you how to forget by showing you something bigger. So decide to forget. So I reach. I decide to forget. So I press. So I'm realizing now, Minister Rick, that God moves with my motives. Yeah, he moves with my motives. It's not always based on just what he wants. He watches my motives. I'm trying, Geraldine, do the best I can. Listen, so I've seen people. You got to be careful with who and what you cancel in this season. That's it, Ashley. That was the golden night, to release some people from where they've been. Listen. I've seen folk who leave your life for a while. I'll talk about me. There are folk who left when we went from building to building. From building to building. What time? Okay, I got 15 minutes. From building to building. But here's the problem that I have, Minister Mays, is that if you leave me while I'm in transition, not Mr. Mays, I'm my friend. I want to talk about people who left. Here's the title of them who left. You ready? Them. Okay. Those who left while we were building, because they didn't want to give in transition. Didn't want to sow in transition. Didn't want to grind in transition. And then once you built, that's it, Nikki, them. They didn't want to build them or they. They didn't want to build in transition. They said, oh, they ain't going to do nothing. They ain't worried about nothing. And then once you built, they want to come back and say, I was a part of the other. But here's the problem. When you come back, you can't come back to where I am, because where I am is not where I was. Remember, where I am is not where I was, because what was never comes again. Even if it comes again, it's not what was, it's what is from what was. So So therefore, where I am is not where I was. So when you come back again, you come back to where you were and not to where I was. And so, no, we're still not where we are because there's a development in transition. There's a development in going through. There's a development in learning how to deal with things. And therefore, I can no longer miss my development because my development is not for where I am. It's from where I'm going. And the reason why I can forget those things which are behind me is because I have to make sure they don't have a hold on me while I reach forth to those things which are before me. I press toward the mark, which means I don't let go. So let me talk. And what will come back? What will come back? Who are them that will come back in the new process? They will come back, but there are three things that are happening, and I gotta teach some people in case they play this in the off season. There are three things that happen. The reason why people don't come back is because number one, Satan makes you comfortable or makes them comfortable in the lack of commitment. It makes them comfortable in the lack of commitment. So coming back isn't an option. While I'm going through, Maria, I don't want to come back while you're working. I want to come back while you're enjoying. I got an answer for you, though. I got an answer. Then number two, that they want to come back to the place where you were when you're no longer there. The place where you were is no longer where you are. So they really can't find you. Huh. And so not being able to find you makes it difficult for them to stay in a place where they thought you'd be. But they missed the development in transition. Can we go? Number three. It's simply pride. I'm talking to some people on here right now. They don't want to admit it. It's okay. It's 61 people. It's always 10%. Listen, pride won't let you admit why and how you left. So you just stay remaining in pride and living outside the divine and perfect will of God. Woo! It is major to know that God has prepared and planned something for you in a particular place and you can't get it because pride won't let you admit that you weren't really committed to the process. Okay. That's why some things you have to forget. Didn't mean you don't remember it. It means it no longer has a place in your life that makes your emotions respond to it. It means you have to neglect it. Yeah. Epolanthomia. You have to neglect it. So you don't allow the bitterness of it to take root in your heart. You have to be careful because you ever seen people... I've seen a movie. I'll be nice. You ever seen a movie where people return when the battle is over? You go into a fight and you see that it was five of y'all when the fight started. And then all of a sudden, it's four of y'all fighting. And you at home and you realize there's somebody missing. Okay, I gotta go. I got seven minutes. You got somebody missing. And you realize somebody left during the battle. So. And then when the battle is over, they come and say, "Y'all all right? What happened?" 9 times out of 10, the four gonna jump on the one. Because you left and then you returned when the battle was over. Let me give you this point and I'm getting out of here. If they can't help you win the battle, they shouldn't be trusted to carry your spoil. Yeah. That's a good one, Bree. Okay. If they can't help you win the battle, they shouldn't be trusted to carry your spoils. See, it's when you can admit it that grace shows up, forgiveness shows up, and then we forget it. Y'all missed it. See, Tia, it's when you can forget it. When you can admit it, then we can forgive it, forget it, and restore. See, It's when you come back and act as if nothing happened. Hey, y'all good? Hey, how you doing? How you doing? No. Not how am I doing? Where were you while we were in back? Where were you while we were going through? Where were you if they cannot help you win the battle. And watch this. Can I go a little further? Can I go a little further? Just because you present don't mean you helped. Come on, Cedric Mackey. Just because you present doesn't mean that you helping. Because there are some people who are present who are riding. Okay. If I had a coat and my coattail was long, if you're on my coattail, it makes it hard for me to pull. But if you're up beside me, it makes the pull easier. Everybody who's present doesn't mean they're helping. So if you can't help me win the battle, then put your hands down. Don't expect to be trusted to carry my spoil. Oh, it's where we at now. This is our new building. No. Your new building was next door. Can I talk? It was torn down. Come on, Maria, hang in there. The place where you were was the old building that got torn down because it was mold in the building. The ceiling leaked. And here's a question for you. Did the ceiling leak because you didn't help pay? You didn't seed? You didn't tithe for all that was going on? Did the building go no good because of the fact that you wasn't there to give your portion? Or did the building go bad because it was just no good? It's okay now. Now it's a new building, new roof. And now we have a new place to be. And so now you want to come to carry spoils that you never helped in battle. I must get through. Because there is a development in your go-through that's required for the next season of your life that God is bringing us into. The next season of our life. He's bringing us into that season, and it's a place where we have to go and just trust God in spite of how it's been. You got to forgive, and now you have supernatural prophetic revelation. You must forget, which means you have to see it, not respond to it. You have to neglect it. You have to ignore it. There's a go-through that creates your development. God's bringing us into it now. You can't keep mourning over your bad past. Forget it. Come on. Grace is getting you. You can't keep mourning over that. You can't keep grieving over what you messed up on. Forget it. It's keeping you from forgiving. Because every time it comes back, you think about it. And because you haven't forgot it in the form you just learned, you tend to hold on to it. And then God will start to put things in front of you that are bigger. And it'll frustrate you because people on your left and your right will begin to achieve the greater. And the devil will start to have you pointing fingers at them. Hating on people you should be connected to come through to the next thing that God has for your life. You can't keep mourning and grieving over your bad past. You can't even keep celebrating over your good past too long, because while you're jumping with your hands up, the devil is pumping himself up to punch you in your ribs and make you lose all the air in your body. Because celebrating doesn't take you forward. Doesn't take you forward. It just gives you somewhere to talk too long. It keeps you from preparing for your next move. And so, Father, we thank you tonight for those who are preparing to forgive and forget. Forgetting those things which are behind them and reaching forth to the greatness that is before them. God, tonight, help us to press beyond where we are. Come on. That's it, Tia. Pray your own prayer. Father, we thank you tonight that you're carrying us beyond where we've been too long. You're opening up doors. that we thought were closed. But really, it's because we were looking at what was minimal and not looking at the greatness before us. We were looking in our rearview mirror and not taking retrospect what you placed in front of us. So tonight, Father, we pray right now that every blockage be opened in Jesus' name. We pray now that every area of blockage be removed and that we're able to press forward, that we're able to deal with the process of forgiving and forgetting. So God, as we're looking at the process that we have not forgot, help us to first forgive ourselves. Come on, Yamika Matthews. Help us to forgive ourselves. Come on, Brianna. As we forgive ourselves, you know, come on, we got to move forward. If my people, which you call by my name, humble themselves and pray, seek my face and turn. There must be a turning. Can't say, God, forgive me, and continue the same journey. The forgetting is not allowing what was to disturb the peace of what is and what is to come. So, Father, we give you praise and we give you glory in Jesus' name. There may be somebody here that says, Pastor, that word was just for me. I'm not saved tonight, but I got to connect with God in order for God to do what it is in my life He's designed me to do. If that's you and you know you're not saved and you don't know Jesus, it's our goal tonight to watch you move from a life of sin into a life of grace. If that's you, please put on here, it's me. It's me. Come on, it's me. Take the opportunity tonight, it's me, so I can forgive myself first and then forget what I've done and watch God move me into what's next in my life. In Jesus' name. I said it before, we've not valued the word of God. We read stuff, we read everything, and ignore the word of God, put it second. And God going, I see Tia right there. It's not about what you place second or first. It's your priority, how you overlooked, underrated, and improperly handled my word. I know other words are good. I know other words may be true, but God says it's my word that you can't handle haphazardly. You must handle it. You know, it's fragile because there's enough power in his word to make what he said come to pass. Tia Blackman is one that we're praying for tonight. We're already prayed. Already prayed. So let's pray with her now. Father, we thank you for this heart, for this soul that openly, willingly admitted. This word caught her, and she could admit, hey, it's me. I need to get myself together so I can walk throughout the things that God has for me. No more blockages for me. I need to first forgive me so I can forget the worst of me and receive the greater and the best of me. In Jesus' name. I believe Jesus Christ died and rose again on the third day for me. So since he counts me worthy enough, I count myself worthy enough. So tonight, Father, come on, type it on here, Tia Blackman. I am worth it. Christ died because you're worth it. I am worth it. Oh, Jesus, I'm a minute over. Come on, I am worth it. And anybody else who wants to join her, just in the spirit of this moment, type I am worth it. In the spirit of this moment, type, I am worth it. The word he sent you, the heart he's given you, you've overlooked, underrated, and improperly handled it. God says, no, I need you to now recognize I sent you a great word because you're worth it. I see you, Nicole. I am worth it. I see you, Nicole. I see you, Brittany. I see you, Minister Ricks. I see you, Aaron Fleeks. I see you, Breonna Lane. I'm worth it. I see you. Come on. I see y'all. I see you, Raquel. I'm worth it. I see you, Tamina Ricks. I'm worth it. Manny Saeed, I'm worth it. I see you. You are. Yes, you are. Eric Trotman, yes, you are. Tanya Reed, Tanya Green, yes, you are. Deja Young, yes, you are. Young Family, yes, you are. Emery Shelvin, yes, you are. You're worth it in Jesus' name. Brandy Lane, yes, you are. You're worth it. Now, when you're saying you're worth it, Trish Wells, I need you to act as if you're worth it by knowing how much value the word that comes to you has. So you don't neglect it. See, when you neglect, come on, Pat, watch this. When you neglect the word that was sent, then you forget the word. Mm. You can't forget. The word forget means to neglect. You can no longer neglect the word. And so, Father, I give you praise. I give you honor. I give you glory. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. I pray this word has helped you. I'm still on sabbatical. I was trying to do 30 minutes, and the word was so powerful. I said, God, just give me like 45 minutes and talk to Mr. Mays. Got it all situated. We got it right. Listen, I pray this word has blessed your life. I pray. There it is. I pray that you forget. I pray that tonight that you forget. I pray what the devil's been holding you back with that you forget. I pray you forget it right now. I pray you forget it. I pray you forget it. I pray that you to lose out of your mind. Epilanthamaya. I pray that you lose it out of your mind. Didn't say remove. It said lose. No, Mr. Mays, I'm done. Because if this right here was rich, No. No longer can you neglect the word. Yeah. Epilanthonomia. That's how you pronounce that word. No longer will you ignore his word. No longer will you lose it out of your mind. Watch this. It's so important, Minister Ricks. The Bible calls a reprobate is somebody who did not retain the word of God, which means they lost it out of their mind. It means they forgot it or neglected it. And God says it makes you reprobate. Oh, which means he turns you over to yourself. No, that won't be us tonight. We're going to walk in freedom. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Minister Mays. God bless you. Praise team, you're now in the hands of Minister Marcus Mays. I thank you tonight, Father, that greater is in front of us. In Jesus' name. You know, I said before, people have mishandled God's word, mishandled the prophetic and the prophet. I think these last few days of sabbatical, I'm going to just take a real sabbatical. I'm out. I've been open to everybody and everything. And been trying, and I had some things planned, and the Lord said no. Whenever the Lord tells me no about something I have planned that's not a bad thing, then there's something God is doing. So I need you to be praying so God can speak to you. And so God bless. We'll see y'all on Friday for 30 minutes in the morning, maybe. If not, we'll see you on Sunday. Got it? We'll see you forgiven and forgetting the things that's been in your life that the enemy has used to hold you back. Take care. God bless. This is Life Pastor Kyle, Prophet Dexter Kyle of some, Spiritual Father to others, and some just Pastor Kyle. Just here to make sure that the word goes forth, that people get the help they need to forget those things which are behind them and reach forth to what's before them. Let's press tonight. No more blockage. In Jesus' name. God bless you. Peace. Take care. Have a good night. Bye-bye.